So back in December last year, Google announced the latest version 5 of their TPUs. Following on from that, at Google I/O this year, they announced TPU 6s. Now, the TPU 6s are nearly 5 times faster compared to the earlier TPU 5s. And those TPU 5s are about 2.7, 2.8 times faster than the previous TPU 4s. Now, why am I talking about this? Because the original Gemini Ultra model was trained on TPU 4s. So many of them, in fact, that they had to split it across data centers. Now, with the increase in TPU 5s and TPU 6s, this has opened up a whole new world for Google to make lots of models, be able to serve those models and experiment with those models. And as of today, in Google AI Studio, we're seeing the latest release of some of these experiments. So you can see that as of today, there are 3 new versions of the Gemini models in Google AI Studio that you can go and try out. And these are the Gemini 1.5 Pro experimental model, 0827, the 1.5 Flash experimental model, and a new 1.5 Flash 8 billion model. That's right, an 8 billion parameter model on the sort of size of something like a Llama 3 that's a Flash model. And if you've been following Archive, the recent update to the Gemini 1.5 paper actually has a whole bunch of details about this model. So this model is a version of Flash, and I should stress that this is just an experiment. And this kind of sets the tone for a lot of where the Gemini team is going, is that they're constantly exploring new versions of the models, new fine tunes, trying out different data sets, all this kind of thing. And having those new TPUs, you could imagine, suddenly speeds up the rate of acceleration for these experiments. So if we look at the paper in here, they talk about that, you know, the Flash 8B is basically inheriting the same kind of architecture and optimizations and data mixture refinements as its larger Flash counterpart. It can also handle 1 million tokens, just like the previous big one. The key difference with this model is that because of its size, it's basically optimized for high throughput and low latency uses. And this is an area of the market that I think a lot of people are starting to realize is really important, that when you want a model that can respond with really low latency, be fast, but still be a good model, people have been turning to things like Haiku, like the original Gemini Flash model, like a GPT-4o mini, etc. The experiment with this model is to basically see, okay, are people interested in something that is even faster than that and allows you to basically churn through, you know, a lot of tokens really quickly with this kind of thing. So in the paper, they talk about use cases for this, one of them being this large-scale data labeling. Certainly, this kind of model can do a lot of tasks where you just need it to do things like classification, perhaps some extraction work, that kind of thing. It performs really well for that. The other use case that I certainly found interesting, and I guess I should point out that I've been one of the people testing this model, is the high throughput agent serving idea here, is that for when you want agents to do lots of calls really quickly, to basically break something down, to check it out, to be able to do a whole bunch of different calls, whether that's for like summarization, like the summarization app I made a video about, whether that's for simple decision-making or extracting things out that you want to use with an agent, this model can definitely perform a lot of the grunt work where you just don't need the most intelligent model in there. And then, of course, you have the ability to use a different model for when you do need certain specific decisions made that you need more intelligence, etc. Another interesting use case of the model is its multimodality. So things like just getting it to check an image to see, okay, is something in an image, you know, is there text in an image? What's the text in the image? That kind of thing is where this model can do those tasks at a very high speed. So in the paper, they do have a whole bunch of benchmarks, and clearly we can see that the Flash 8B doesn't perform as well as Flash. It's, you know, quite a bit behind on some of the reasoning and stuff like that, and of course on things like MMLU, etc. The goal with this really is just to have a very quick model as opposed to having a very intelligent model in here. So at the same time that they've released the Flash 8B model, there's also two other new experimental models, a new version of Pro, which the Gemini team is claiming to be the best version of Gemini Pro 1.5 that they've released so far, and the same thing for Flash. So those are definitely worth checking out as well. And because of these are experimental models, they put all of these on unique endpoints with the date 0827 in the actual experimental model release in there. If we look at the Lmsys chatbot arena update, these models have been in testing out there for a bit. You can see that the new Gemini Pro now is second on the leaderboard, just behind the latest GPT-4o, as well as the new Gemini Flash, which again, I think is one of the sort of key models in here, also jumping up massively to number 6 on the leaderboards in here. And then finally, if we look at the new Gemini Flash 8B, it's not only outperforming the Gemma 2 9 billion, but it's sort of matching Llama 3 70B levels in here. So that's certainly an interesting thing to see. I think it shows that certain companies really are focusing on getting data mixes to be able to make these models get a lot better. Now, that said, I certainly don't base my own interpretations just on the Lmsys chatbot arena anymore. I do think there's a number of things going on where people are optimizing the models for things like Markdown, etc., which is allowing them to get better scores in that format. And I think there are some other things that could be going on there as well. Anyway, let's jump in and have a look at the models in the code and have a little play with it. Okay, so in the code, I'm going to have a look. Mostly, I'm going to focus on the latest Flash 8B model, but I'll also have a look at some of the other new models that we've got in here as well. We've got the 1.5 Flash 8B, the 1.5 Flash Experimental, and then we've also got the new Pro Experimental as well. So you'll see, looking at these, I've just gone through and just done some tests to make sure that they're working. One of the things you will notice is that in theory, the 8B should be faster. But it's not always faster. Now, I think there's two reasons for that. One, in theory, the 8B is going to be a lot faster for things where throughput is the key thing. So meaning like a lot of tokens in versus tokens out there. The other thing too is that it does seem that if you're going for short responses like this, so I'm just testing to see if they hallucinate a response in here to the 2024 Olympics results. But anyway, one of the things you'll notice is that often it'll appear that the 8B takes longer than the non-8B flash. And like I said, that I think has got a lot to do with that the 8B is faster for throughput. Also, because the 8B is an experimental configuration, my guess is it's not fully set up and optimized as much as it could be for TPUs for the moment. That said, you'll see as I go through some of these that it certainly can be faster than the other one when we're doing things with lots of throughput and generating longer sequences out, etc. All right, so I've put together a simple generate function here where we're going to look at the Flash 8B, the Flash Experimental, and the Pro Experimental, both experimentals being the latest ones in here. Now, you'll see that generally, not so much in this first one, but generally the 8B and the normal Flash will be quite similar, but you'll see that the results out from the Pro will be quite different. So in this particular one, we can see that the 8B is 4.7 seconds, the Flash Experimental is 5.3 seconds, and sure enough, the Pro is just under 11 seconds there. And this is something that you see quite consistently going through this. Jumping forward a bit to the sort of standard write an email question, we do see that clearly the reasoning of the Pro model seems to be better and its results tend to be longer and tend to be more fleshed out in here compared to the other two. The other two, often I would say, sometimes they're doing things very similar, sometimes they're different, but quality-wise, I don't think there's a huge difference. The question comes down to, are you getting a faster output from the Flash 8B? Now, you'll see that ones where the output is really short like this, often the experimental flash is actually faster than the 8B for this. Both of them are always way quicker though than the Pro model in here. Once the length of these things often starts to get a bit longer, you do start to see that the 8B being faster than the experimental model in here. And again, both of them way faster than the Pro. An interesting thing that I noticed in all three of these models now is that they're following system prompts for certain things much better. So if you've watched my videos in the past, I've complained about that when you ask it to be succinct and give sort of a one-word answer even, it would often still say London is the capital of England kind of thing. Now, all three of them have changed to basically just being London, 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 whether I ask for one word answer or just ask for a succinct answer. So that seems to be a change in all three of the new experimental models there. I'll leave it for you to go through and look at these yourself. You'll find that sometimes the 8B model lacks a little bit of finesse. So that you'll see, for example, that with the experimental flash, we've got a title here, but we don't have that on the 8B. Now, that said, though, we don't have a great title necessarily on the Pro one either, although there is a title there. For things like GSM 8K, I definitely notice when I'm doing it with a much wider group of the GSM 8K style questions that the Flash 8B tends to not do the sort of step-by-step chain of thought reasoning as well as the experimental models, and certainly as well as the Pro model in there. That said, in the notebook I've got here, all three of them seem to get the correct answer out here. When we look at the React prompts, we can see that they all generally seem to do fine with this. We're not getting huge discrepancies in those. The other one that I did find interesting to see with this is refusals. How does it handle refusals and stuff like that? In an earlier version, I found that you could actually get around some of the refusals in the 8B model, although the newer version seems to have fixed that up quite well, and all of them seem to basically give similar refusals now. The last one that I thought is interesting to look at is this long text test. I've got two lots of text in here. One is about 8,000 words on the importance of effective promotion of a nightclub in New York, which I'll talk about in a future video, how this came about. And the other one is basically that combined with an introduction to Italy and from the purpose of finding things from the Roman Empire and stuff like that. So the first one is just the NYC stuff. The second one is both of them combined. So these work out to be about 9,000 to 10,000 words in total. And this is where we can certainly see some of the perhaps the weakness of the 8B model. So looking at this, I'm fitting this in. I'm asking it to do a high quality summarization. We get a decent summary out for the Flash 8B for looking at the first one. We get our okay summaries for all three of them here. When we pass in both texts here, we see that the Flash 8B, let's look at the other ones first. So look at the experimental. We see that we get a summary of the NYC stuff and then a summary of the Italy and Rome stuff. Now that's the same for the normal Flash and for the Pro model in here. Both of them work out that actually these are two documents. So we've got text one, text two, even though they're totally joined in there. And this is one of the strengths for doing things like summarization and having it find the topics and stuff like that. This has been one of the strengths of the Gemini models for Pro and even for Flash in the past. Now, that said, the 8B model, when given both texts, only gets the second text. So it ignores the whole thing about the NYC part and just focuses in on the Rome part, the second and most recent text in there. It does seem to me there are definitely issues in getting this to respond to the full context that you're passing in here. Now, that said, I tried one more sort of test with this, and this is where I asked it, okay, I give it the long text, but I basically say to it only to focus in on things related to NYC. And sure enough, now the Flash model has no problem at finding the NYC nightclub stuff and putting that in there and ignoring the Roman stuff. Experimental model, again, we get a better summarization, but it's also ignored the Roman stuff. And then actually the Pro is doing, you know, quite well for this. Unfortunately, I ran out of quota running this for the nth time going through this. I feel like this is what highlights to me that I'd probably stick with the Flash experimental for most things. And I would need a really specifically good use case to move to the 8B, or it would have to be massively cheaper for that. Final test, basically just taking the 8B and trying some stuff out for images. So just passing in this image, sure enough, it can give us a good description of the image without any sort of prompt. It gets that quite well. If we give it a prompt and ask it, okay, give me the name of the planet, what movies featured this planet, it does well. Does nowhere near as good as the Pro model or even the other Flash model tends to give longer answers and more movies, etc. here. And then finally, submitting two images for comparisons, and I've squeezed this image here now. It's done an okay job of understanding that both of these are different planets, but it's gone from thinking that it's Saturn to now thinking that it's Neptune. And so we've got the Earth and Neptune as opposed to the Earth and Saturn in here. So that's something different that the Pro model normally wouldn't make a mistake at. So overall, I'm very bullish on the new experimental Flash model, the new experimental Pro model, the 8B model quite a bit less so for the time being until they basically either make it a lot faster or it turns out to be a lot cheaper. Anyway, as always, I'd love to hear your comments on what you found playing with the models yourself, running your own prompts through it. It is really interesting to see what a large lab like DeepMind and the Gemini team who's making some of these models, what they can actually do with an 8B model. And I think this is really fascinating to see. Like, it would be probably awesome if they were actually open sourcing this model. And who knows, maybe in the future we perhaps will see something like this get open sourced. For now, though, it's great to see from the Gemini team that they're just pushing out so many experimental models and constantly iterating and improving and getting feedback and changing things. So I do think we're in a new age of where you're going to see, as new foundation and frontier models come out, that we're seeing those be iterated on many times. This is one of the reasons why I say to a lot of people around the Gemini models, if the last time that you tried them was the start of the year, you definitely should be going back and trying them now, because they've iterated to be way better than they were for some of the early versions. And we've got to think that all these experiments are going towards working out what is the best data set, what is the best curation strategies, etc. for Gemini 2, which you could imagine is just around the corner. As always, if you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. Let me know any comments, etc. down below. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.